Hello dear students, I wish you all are staying safe at your homes and welcome back to my video sessions. So in my previous video, I have just covered the meaning as well as the features of depreciation. In my today's video, we will discuss methods of providing depreciation, right? So let's get started with our very first method of providing depreciation, that is straight line method. Now, why this is called original cost method too? Fixed installment method too, I'll explain. See, now in this method, we just have to calculate depreciation on the original cost or acquisition cost of an asset. For example, if I have purchased machinery for 5 lakh, right, then we have to divide the depreciation or the rate of depreciation every year on 5 lakh only. Because it is to be calculated on the original cost, that is why this is also called original cost method. Now, in this case, every year we have to use a fixed amount of depreciation. That is why this is also called fixed installment method. Right? Now, see, let's take an example to elaborate it. Now, for example, the cost of machinery is 5 lakh. Means we have purchased machinery for rupees 5 lakh. The rate of depreciation is given, that is 10%. Now, this rate is to be divided on the original cost, that is 5 lakh. It means depreciation is equals to the original cost of an asset multiplied by the rate, that is 50,000. It means every year we just have to use this 50,000 amount of depreciation. It means we will charge this 50,000 in P&L account, or you can say that we will reduce our asset by 50,000 every year till it will reduce to zero, right? Now see, the amount of depreciation is 50,000, right? So even if, for example, I have just purchased the machinery in 2015, then the depreciation will be 50,000, and the end of 2015, the cost of machinery will reduce to 4,50,000, right? Means 50,000 we will reduce every year from the original cost till it will become zero. Right? Now see, in 2016 again we have to use fixed amount of depreciation, that is 50,000. So the cost will reduce to 4 lakh. Even in next year, in 2017, same we will use 50,000 depreciation and the cost will reduce to 3 lakh 50. So this is how we have to use this fixed amount of depreciation every year in case of straight line method in order to calculate the actual cost of our fixed asset after a year. You all know that depreciation means that wear and tear of an asset after using it or after a passage of time. So that we have to calculate. So it means if this is reducing by 50,000 every year, so what is the cost at the end of the year we are having? Okay. Now the first mode is if rate of depreciation is given, then we have to simply levy on the original cost and we will get our amount of depreciation. Now, if the rate is not given in the question, then what we have to do? Then we have to use a very simple formula, that is depreciation is equals to original cost minus scrap value. Means the value of an asset which is equal to scrap, we will deduct that from the original cost and it will be divided by estimated life. Estimated life means the life of an asset that we have estimated that it will belong for 5 years, 6 years, 7 years. So we just have to estimate, we have to assume it. कि ये जो हमारी इसकी life है वो इतने साल के बाद क्या है वो बिल्कुल खत्म हो जाएगी. Now see. Now let's take an example for this. See, on 1st April 2015, Atul Glass Limited purchased a machine for 90,000 and spent 6,000 on its carriage, 4,000 on its erection. You know that whatever is spent on the day when we are purchasing any fixed asset, that will be added to the cost. It means the actual cost of the machine is 90,000. Plus 6,000 plus 4,000, right? It's 1 lakh. Means the cost of machine is 1 lakh. Okay? Now the date of purchase, it was estimated that the effective life of machine will be 10 years. So the life will always be given in the question, right? And scrap will you see. After 10 years, its scrap value will be 20,000. Now what we have to do? Now, what is our formula? Our formula is original cost minus the scrap value upon estimated life. So, original cost is given 1 lakh in the question, right? This is given 20,000 and estimated life is given 10,000. It means the depreciation is equals to 8,000. Is that okay? So, this is how we have to calculate our depreciation. Now, see how we have to maintain our asset account as well as our depreciation account in order to show the affecting workings of depreciation. Now see what we have to write on the top of the account. It's machinery account, right? Then you know that all accounts are prepared in a T format. Then make a T format, right? It's one-sided debit, another one is credit. A very simple format is there, that is date, particulars, amount, then again date, particulars, amount. Now see, you all know that whenever we purchase any fixed asset, then what is the journal entry that we pass? That is machinery account debit to bank or cash, right? So this is the journal entry that we generally pass with the amount given. Suppose it is 1 lakh that we have now just calculated after adding all the expenses. So it means if it is machinery account debit to bank, so in machinery account we have to write down to bank. Now the date will be its acquisition date, means on which date we have purchased. For example, it's 2015 and 1/4 means 1/4 on 1st April we have purchased. So we will write here to bank. What is the amount here? It is 1 lakh. Right? Now what is the journal entry for depreciation? It is depreciation account debit. See, if you know the journal entries, then it is very easy to maintain any account. So please clear your basics first. So the journal entry is depreciation account debit to machinery. Now what is the amount of depreciation we have calculated? See, 8,000. Right? Now we have to use here 8,000. Now see, if it is depreciation account debit to machinery, then in machinery account it will be written as by depreciation. What is the amount? 8,000. Now you know that if the firm is following accounting year, then if the period starts on 1st April, then it will end on 31st March. Then if it is started in 2015, then it will end at 2016, right? So this is how you have to write down by depreciation. Now the value of an asset at the end of the year by writing by balance carry down, CD. Then it's 1 lakh minus 8,000. It's 92,000, right? So same on last day of the year, accounting year, we will write it 31st March by balance carried out. Now we have to balance the both sides. It is 1 lakh. Then we have to close this. Now again on 1/4/2016, we have to brought down. We have to take this amount to the next year by writing to balance brought down. What is the amount? It's 92,000. Again, now we have to divide the depreciation. Again, I will write it 2017 on 31/3. Now, this is the thing you have to learn. Same amount, the fixed amount of depreciation we have to charge. So, I will write here again by depreciation. Again, I will write here 8,000, right? So, again, let's calculate the amount of asset at the end by writing by balance carry down. It is 84,000. So again, balance the both sides, 92,000 and 92,000. So you're getting, this is very, very easy to maintain. You just have to pass the journal entry when you will purchase the any particular asset, then charge depreciation, calculate the balance amount and carry forward this balance amount to the next year by writing balance brought down. Again charge depreciation, the same amount, the fixed amount of depreciation. So this is how you have to calculate till it will become zero, or you have to calculate for the number of years that is already given in the question. If the question will say that calculate, or you can say the prepare machinery account for 4 years, then you have to calculate or you have to just charge depreciation up to 4 years only. Like, it depends upon the question, like for how many years we have to calculate depreciation. Okay, so very simple is this. You can do practice at your home. So please do practice, work hard, and send me your queries. Thank you so much.